Now, mustn't get cold fins.
Don't be shy, Ariel, darling. It's me, your Auntie Ursula.
I shouldn't be here.
Nonsense. We're family.
Father says you're wicked and hateful.
Yes, but he says the same thing of humans, doesn't he, Schnookums? And we both know that's not true. Now, don't we?
Why did he mad at you?
The ocean wasn't big enough for the both of us. And now, he's driven you away, too.
He doesn't understand me.
Oh, but I do, Dumpling. We are so very much alike, you and I. Girls with ambition. Nothing scares a man more. Now, tell your dear old auntie everything.
I'm in love with someone. A human.
Oh, yes. This prince fellow. He's quite a catch. Well, the answer is simple. You've got to become human yourself.
Can you help me?
Help you? My dear sweet child, it's what I live for, to help unfortunate merfolk like yourself, poor souls with no one else to turn to. Now, here's my best offer, babykins. I know a spell that will turn you into a human for 3 days. There's a procedural clause, sort of a squid pro quo. Before the sun sets on the 3rd day, you've got to get dear old Princey Poo to kiss you. If he does, you'll stay human forever.
And if I don't?
Oh, nothing drastic, darling, I'm sure. Oh, look here, small print. Your soul is mine forever, and you're doomed to spend eternity in my watery, hell-soaked lair. Lawyers, don't you just love them? Oh, of course, there is one more thing. My fee.
But I don't have anything.
I'm not asking for much. Only your voice.
My voice?
Mm-hmm. Well, don't worry, darling. I've got the perfect place for it. Your grandpappy Poseidon gave his magic trident to your father. But this was his gift. Pour moi.
Your magic shell.
You've heard about it.
Father says it's the source of all your witchcraft.
Nonsense, darling.
He says you die without it.
Die? Oh, please. It's a bauble, a vessel for your voice. Don't worry, darling. Your legato, your vibrato, even your belt. They'll all be safe and sound in here.
If I give away my voice, how can I ever...
You'll have your looks, your pretty face, and don't underestimate the importance of body language. The men up there don't like a lot of blabber. They think a girl who gossips is a bore. Yes, on land it's much preferred for ladies not to say a word. And after all, dear, what is idle prattle for? Come on! They're not all that impressed with conversation. True gentlemen avoid it when they can. But they don't in swoon and fawn on a lady who's withdrawn. Yes, it's she who holds her tongue, who gets her man. Come on, you poor unfortunate soul. Go ahead. Make your choice. I'm a very busy woman and I haven't got all day. It won't cost much, just your voice. You poor unfortunate soul. It's sad, but true. If you want to cross a bridge, my sweet, you've got to pay a toll. Take a gulp and take a breath and go ahead. Sign the scroll. Flotsam jetsam, now I've got a voice. The boss is on a roll.